So today we're going to be reacting to Beasties GTA 5 series episode 24. Let's get started.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Grand Theft Auto 5. And yes, I am here with Trevor, in his underwear, covered in blood, on an island, by himself, with several dead bikers, I'm guessing? I don't know what happened, or why he's in his underwear, but you know what? We don't need to ask any questions. I think we've learned from Trevor that anything is impossible when he is on meth, and by possible, of course, I mean murdering several bikers on an island by himself. And I don't even want to know why he's in his underwear, but with that being said, I did check the map, and there's actually no jobs available for Trevor, or, well, main story missions, which is unfortunate. But I'm sure at some point he'll get roped into this big job that we're about to do with the FIB that involves us raiding the FIB building. There is actually something down here called Rampage, which I'm not sure what that is. I might do it at some point. I'm sure it involves him killing endless amounts of people, but for now, though, I'm actually going to switch over to Franklin and see what he's doing. Do you want to quit? No, I don't want to quit Grand Theft Auto. What the hell? I'm just starting the video. And I think before we do anything, I want to take Franklin's car down to a custom shop and give it a few upgrades. I did that last time with Michael's car, and I really liked it. So we'll do the same with Franklin.
It's Franklin, man. I'm following the architect.
All right. Don't fuck it up.
All right.
Okay, you're following an architect. Why are we following an architect? You know what? That's fine. Easy job. Tail the architect. It's a far cry from doing jobs with Lamar and ending up with piles of dead bodies. I like this. Franklin P.I.
Hey, stupid. You can't be on here without a hat.
Oh, thank you so much. By the way, the name's not stupid. It's Franklin. Ooh, we have an architect on site. Actually, scratch that. The name's not Franklin. It's Bob the Builder. And I got hella guns. I mean, look at these muscles. I'm a real construction worker. I got all of these muscles by hammering nails into walls, right? That's what construction is, of course. Okay, so we're following a random architect. I'm guessing we're trying to get the blueprints for the FIB building from him, maybe? I guess, I don't know. But, listen, this is way better than doing jobs with Lamar. This way, no one dies. And I might actually get paid. And bonus, there might not be police officers this time. What's up, guys? Real construction worker here.
There is police officers.
The left side. You're kidding me. The bedrock ends there. We need caissons on the east side. No drama. It's a government contract. We'll be paid till completion. I ain't taking a fall for this screw up.
I totally know what they're talking about because I'm a construction worker. The name is Bob the Builder. No, Franklin Bob the Builder. Shit. Took one of those lifts, so I guess I'll take one too. Easy enough, just press the button and up we go. Actually, when I was a kid, I was fascinated with construction workers and the whole job. I always wanted to be on a construction site. It looked so cool. Well, it did back in the day until I got lazy.
Study him and study him hard.
I was gonna wipe my ass on him.
That's the engineer's plan. Mine seems like a religious sect, remember?
Yeah, that's it.
Why do you have such an ego? You're just an architect. You're a nobody. This guy acts like he's some amazing person with his documents. Oh, I design buildings in CAD software. I'm so cool. Why, you're fat. You don't know what it's like to work a real job. Get the architect to give up the briefcase. Well, that shouldn't be too hard. I'm an intimidating guy.
Hello?
What's up, bitch? Give me the plans, fat-ass.
I thought I had final approval on all personnel. Call 911!
Shit! What do you mean I'm armed? I mean, I guess I am a human weapon, but still, I mean, come on, homie, just give me the plans! Alright, Franklin, you gotta work on your right hook, my man. That is just pathetic. Boom, bitch! What's up? Alright, look, boys, I know I was saying I'm a construction worker, but actually, I'm a hustler. I work the streets. I'm used to beating fools up. What's good? Okay, when I said there weren't going to be police officers, that was a bit of an exaggeration. Leave the construction site. Who would have thought beating up a random architect and taking some paper is going to get me in prison and have the cops on me? Jesus Christ. All right, activate elevator. Come on, Franklin. Chop, chop. I mean, I guess I could take this shortcut. Quite a shortcut. I would probably need a whole set of new legs and knees. Hi. I'm the architect. I'm a very unconventional architect. I know I look very buff. And I'm in a beater, and I can apparently just parkour over shit, but listen, I'm a real architect, I promise! There's no need to shoot at me, boys! I mean, this briefcase goes perfectly with my sweats and construction hat, it makes sense. Oh,
We've got Bob the Builder trying to beat me up. This game is insane. All right. There we go. You gonna try and chase me? You want some of this action? All right, bitch. What's up, fools? You think you can hustle like me? You can hang with the big boys? I don't think so. I've killed people for looking at me the wrong way. Actually, no, I haven't. That's Trevor. But still, I'm tough. Okay, well, that ended poorly. I thought for sure that would be the one job where the police wouldn't video on me, but I guess I'm wrong. Go on, bitch, move! I do need to upgrade this car because, wow, seriously? I lost the police that quickly? They got there and they're like, oh, he only killed a few construction workers, an architect, no big deal. Boys, go home. Now, if anyone tries to steal a laundry truck, get their ass. Los Santos police are crazy. I definitely need to upgrade this car because it's really slow and kind of hard to handle, and the white paint job looks hideous. I want something matte this time, like matte black with some sick rims, you know, the whole thing. So let's just go ahead and go to the garment factory and drop off this very valuable briefcase. And I had to clock an architect for it. Good Lord. All right, here we are. And listen, Lester, you won't believe it. I actually had to run away from the police. I know, right? Who would have thought stealing a briefcase would be so dangerous? It is, though. The whole job's dangerous. Being a criminal is very dangerous work. Even if you're trying to steal paperwork, who would have thought?
Ah, Craig. Hey,
what's Craig?
Adam? Of course I do, homie. Here, thank you. So, all good? Sure, homie. So is this shit for real? You just gonna rob the FIB and be allowed to walk by your boys right there?
Yeah, I don't fucking know. Probably not. All right, Lester, what do you got, huh?
I don't quite know yet. Give me a minute. I'm not a fucking computer.
Oh. Oh, maybe I am. Here's what I think. We have two options. The new security software goes into containment mode in case of emergency. You know, earthquakes, mudslides, acts of God. So, plant some fire bombs. They go bang! The emergency call goes out. We hijack it. Show up as firemen, and then we grab the containment drive. Or we could hack the system on site. We'll go in by air. Hope we don't run into too much physical resistance.
Sounds relaxed. Either bombing our office ran by a division of corrupt government psychos, or defeating one of the world's most complex security systems using our worthless ass ninja skills, huh?
Yeah. Any, many, money, mo. If you favor the firebomb containment drive option, you'll go in with that janitor's ID you picked up. It'll be at night when most of the workers are off. You'll mop the place and plant the bombs where we need them. Seriously.
I got a mop?
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
You really do. They'll clock you on the cameras if you're play acting. You also need a fire truck to show up in when the bombs go off, and a getaway car stashed in a quiet place near the bureau so you can torch the truck and get out. The car doesn't have to be anything special. There shouldn't be any heat.
What about the other way? The ninja skills.
Now you choose that route, you won't be using the janitor's gear, but we had to cover all the bases. Your FIB paymasters will have to provide you with a chopper and a pilot. Now you fly way up above the building, parachute in, and gain access through the roof here. Then you'll need to be armed to the teeth, mind you, just in case the shit goes down.
Bopping or parachuting? Wow, you're making this choice really difficult.
Oh, come on, Michael!
Given us the leftover money from the Polito job to pull this mission, the crew will be paid out of that. So, what's it gonna be?
I don't know. This is a tough choice. I mean, on one hand, I absolutely hate mopping, but on the other hand, jumping out of a helicopter into a building, you know, that's just as bad as mopping. You lazy ass. Okay, you know what? Obviously, either way, it's going to go poorly. You already know the police are going to show up. I'm going to have to kill a bunch of people. You're going to have to escape the police. So, really, any option we choose is probably going to go south very quickly. But with that being said, I do like the idea of sneaking in as a janitor and planting bombs. So, let's go with the fire crew.
So you do want them up. Okay. Well, you'll need a couple of gunmen. They'll go in with you as firemen. If everything goes to plan, they won't fire a single bullet. But you will be running into a burning high-rise with them, so consider that.
Okay, so we can choose our crew. Obviously, I don't care about the cut as much, you know, giving them money to do their job. It's not like I'm actually going to play this game after I'm done with the story mode, so let's go with the absolute best people we can. So for the gunmen, Gustavo. He's got the best stats and also the biggest cut, so we're gonna go with him.
Gus Moda. He's a pro. Not much else to say.
Okay, what do we have here? Another gunman. This guy wants 7%. This guy wants 6%. Okay, I don't care about his health as much, but the shooting accuracy and the shooting rate is important, as well as the weapon choice. Actually, both of these guys suck. What the hell? Lester, find some better people, goddammit. Okay, let's go with this guy.
Well, should be okay. He's got a few scores left in him. This is a protected federal building. Are you absolutely sure this is how you want to take it?
I mean, I think we all know it's going to probably go poorly either way, so sure, let's go.
And we have a winner. I'll make arrangements to call you when we're ready.
Bye.
You know, I'm still looking into that union depository gig. Real interesting. But I don't know if we can do it without, you know, well, as long as he can't do it without us.
I mean, at some point, we're going to have to make amends with Trevor. That's not going to be easy. Although, with that being said, just go get him a huge bag of meth. What am I saying? He cooks the shit in his own kitchen. That wouldn't work. What would Trevor want more than anything on Earth? Patricia! But that couldn't happen, right? A getaway vehicle is required for this setup. Oh, not this again. I have to find a getaway vehicle and then park it somewhere next to the Bureau building. Okay, well, I'm not using my car as a getaway vehicle. I mean, it's not even possible, but still. Let's grab something really sexy and really fast. And I just realized running there is probably not a great idea.
Daddy? I'm in trouble.
What is it? Money? Drugs? Your mother?
There's this guy. He's been following me around. I think he's about to do something.
What does that mean? Help Tracy? Oh, sure. Where are you?
Vinewood Plaza.
Okay, wait there.
He's been following me in my car, so let's just drive around and you can talk to him when he shows.
Oh, yeah. We'll talk.
Yeah, for sure. We'll talk. Yeah. I mean, well, he won't be doing much talking because I'll have my foot in his mouth. I mean, not that I care about Tracy, you understand. She's actually kind of insane. But still, I do enjoy beating people. All right, well, let's go find this guy that's following my wannabe porn star daughter. Now, what could I do to him? I could break his teeth. I like how last time Michael gave that guy from Fame or Shame a dick tattoo on his chest. Multiple piercings, and he cut off his little man ponytail. Aw, poor guy. Whatever will he do? All right, here we are. What's up, Tracy? Where's your stalker?
Daddy, where are you going?
Whoa. That's your car? I'm sorry, but I cannot be
Let's
seen
go find him.
In a car like that. That is embarrassing. Do you see my whip? Why don't you get that? It's fast. It's real fast. It looks
get
sexy.
Calm
down. I am not going to be caught dead in a car like that. First, you guys got to go into the gun store and pick up some really weak new weapons.
You have something used on yourself or others.
Did you say use on myself? He's still yelling in the background. Use on myself? No, thank you. I'm not into suicide as of lately. Right now, I just want to get a couple of new weapons because your boy actually has nothing. Let's see now. Hold up. I know this is kind of off topic or off the mission, but that's fine. Listen, Tracy, calm down. I'll get to it in a moment. Let's get a stun gun.
One of them will show an XYBUV business.
I don't know what type of customers you get, homie, but you know what? I don't even want to know. Mini gun, hell yes. Okay, and then let's get one more random weapon just because. Let's go with the musket. That's pretty stupid. All right, thank you so much, sir.
I'll use that the second you get out the door.
I am very worried about your customers, but listen, thank you so much, and I gotta go save my daughter from a stalker. Listen, Tracy, you probably brought it on yourself, you know? Because technically, if you think about it, you were on Fame or Shame, which means you were out there flashing your boobs and shaking your butt, so you brought this on yourself.
I last saw him around the corner. Hawaiian Snow.
Hawaiian Snow? What the hell
looking
type of place
guy,
is that?
Purple convertible. I don't remember what name.
Okay, I'll keep an eye out.
Thanks, Daddy.
Hey, what are dads for, huh? I mean, other than giving you money, putting a roof over your head, speaking to guys who ridicule you on TV.
Well, he's not here, I don't think.
Here?
No, he's not around. We should try that motel opposite the big construction site.
Listen, I thought you said he was a stalker.
And a scientist.
Your boobs. You better not be taking out credit for some brother.
Not
Morgan's upset, he is crazier than Trevor.
Hey, creepo, I'm her father, not a sugar daddy.
You've raised a great kid, Mr. Sucks. You're an entrepreneurial.
Oh, is that a fancy way of saying she's a porn star? Get your ass over here. I've got a shotgun with your name on it.
Baby. There's some real creeps out there.
Yeah, guys from the strip club, hookers.
Hey!
Hey, that ain't me. Anymore.
Well, that was you 5 minutes ago. Pull over, bro. I just got a new fancy stun gun.
You've got a great job.
Yeah, well, it's hard raising kids in this town. Come here, scumbag.
Okay, am I supposed to, like, shoot him or something? I don't want to kill him until the dialogue's over.
Dad, I can't live like this.
Oh, shut up.
I can't go out of the house. I can't go online.
How did he find you on the web?
Got up? The hell is this? reach, little stun gun? Okay, well, apparently I'm gonna have to kill this guy with an old-timey musket. Oh, bitch! Damn, that ripped a hole through his back. What good now, creep? You're dead. What good? You like that? See, I told you, you wouldn't even feel it. Well, he did feel it. I shot him in the back once, and he ran like an idiot. Okay, well, I just put a man down with a musket for stalking my porn star daughter. Oh, and the police are on me. Jesus Christ. Okay. See, Michael, you wanted your family back, but now that you got him back, it's all kind of bad. Okay, all right. I am kind of screwed here. Well, assuming the police don't catch up to me, I will be right back. Okay, that took forever. I ran so far chasing that dude down. He looks like a creep, but Jesus, he must be an athlete or something. What the hell is wrong with your car,
what
Tracy?
What happened, Daddy?
This guy had an accident.
What? You've been trying to ring me. What?
What?
Did you say you've been trying to ring me?
Yeah.
Why?
Well, just to see
I'm on my way. Okay. He complains about me ringing you, but now you're ringing me. I didn't use my phone before, I used my Alexa like every time. Yeah, because I've connected my contacts to my Alexa. So it says the same thing as the contacts.
Well, I've got this sandwich, an egg one.
Okay, you fetch it up then.
And I'm sorted.
Was the door locked?
Nope.
Well, probably not then. Check the second room. I'm about to fall. Why did you let me have it that overtime?